Found me in a basket, she said. Smack her for me. Everybody grows up.
The GOP nominee working to court black voters, speaking earlier at a predominantly black church, promising to continue the legacy of Lincoln by reforming the very system that he claims has kept the community oppressed. Also this hour, tracking her mean, no longer a hurricane, but the post-tropical cyclone continues to pick up steam off the Atlantic. One life lost, thousands in the dark. Residents from Virginia to New Jersey bracing for a devastating storm surge. Our teams are standing by across the storm zone with proof of just how powerful Hermine is.
The authorities here in Virginia Beach are currently
giving us a little smile. Don't be a smart patootie. Give me a smile.
What happened? How come you used to be cute?
I've been cute as long as you've known me.
But
then,
you're
still cute when I see you. All right, Mother, tell me some sort of story about something. Tell me when you met Dad. How'd you meet Dad? Well, no, I don't even. Well, when did it happen? You can turn that down, please.
I was about 14. And
turn that down, Mom, please.
When I was 14, I decided I was going to marry him.
So important. I am here today to listen.
But I went out with other boys. I did not stay home. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I was at the door.
So where did you meet him, though, when you were 14? School?
Church. Oh. He came to fellowship, which we went to, and I was born with another boy, more or less. As much as you can go when you're that age, you just sit on somebody's lap and you think you're being very wild. And that boy went to our church, and somebody brought him to church, to the fellowship, and I thought, I'm going to marry him. And in the meantime, I had a lot of fun. We dated off and on, but when he wasn't around, I was not home. Not me. Too much fun out there. Was fun.
Now, did he date other girls?
Sure he did. We both dated others, but I knew I wanted to marry him. But I mean, that I wasn't waiting around for him to ask me out. I went out with anybody that would take me dancing.
So what was the status?
She was wild child.
What was the status of your relationship when he went into service? You weren't engaged or you were?
No, but we wrote. We just weren't born. We were just dating.
Okay, so you weren't engaged, okay.
We wrote back and forth. And we came home. I forget now. It was fun. That was a cheap date. A date was walking 3 miles to get ice cream and then walking 3 miles back. That was a cheap date. But we thought that was fun.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody did, of my gang.
Everyone walked a lot. Did I go to the drive-in?
Mm-hmm.
Did I go to the drive-in movies, ever?
A couple of times. Mostly we went to Westerns every week. We watched a Western. And we went with...
You mean at a movie? You mean at a movie?
We go in a group, you know.
You went to watch a Western movie, you're saying?
Mm-hmm. And then...
What theater would you go to?
Down Hamilton. They were down Hamilton. And Hamilton had a recreation center. And I wish that all neighborhoods had that for the children. I mean, there wasn't any drugs or drinking. It was fun. It was bowling and games and dancing. And it was supervised to a point. It was good, clean fun. We had good, and I feel sorry for the children today. They have so much thrown to them that when you're 14 and 15, you really don't handle it well, you know.
Well, they're bored. They don't have anything to do. Unless they go to
school. They need good, clean fun.
They sit on the computer all the time. That's all they do. Or they text.
A lot. It all depends on your neighborhood. And we just had a good working class, blue-collar neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, you had rules. you mind your mother. If you did something wrong, she was waiting on the porch when you got home. She'd have gotten a phone call. You know what your daughter did?
So did Dad ever walk to your house? I guess he walked to your house, or you
walked? We walked everywhere.
But I mean, you guys walked to each other's houses?
I didn't walk to his house, but he walked to mine.
Mm-hmm. Cause you really lived. You really lived close, though. You really do. That's what I'm saying. You really did live close.
From here to Route 31.
No, I mean, I know how close it is. It's mm-hmm. closer than that. Not that far.
And a lot of bowling alley.
So there was a bowling alley and a movie theater in Hamilton.
Right on Christmas.
Oh, that's right. There's still one in Hamilton.
By the store, by the school.
Yeah, that bowling alley that's still there.
Is it?
That one Dad used to bowl at, that's where you guys went? That's been there forever.
We had a good life.
But the movie theater must have been torn down, I imagine.
It's all changed now.
I mean, there's not a building there, I don't think, that looked like it could have been a movie theater.
I don't know.
Where did y'all go to eat?
Hmm?
Where did y'all go to eat?
Hot Shop.
Mm-hmm. And that's where she
went.
And
there was something called the Towel House, I think.
So what did you like at Hot Shop to eat?
Everything.
And Hot Shop?
The Mighty Moe? The Teen
no,
Twist?
No, we just had ice cream, sodas, and...
But that was in Hamilton?
Huh?
Was the Hot Shops in Hamilton?
I can't hear
Was
that.
It in Hamilton?
Yeah.
Right
it was by the church. Oh, by the okay. Episcopal Church.
Okay.
That was a good restaurant.
Where we grew up, and my mother was so proud. My brother carried the cross, and Ari and I were in the choir. My mother thought we were wonderful. We weren't any better than anybody else. We might have been worse than some. But my mother and father belonged to the Legion. And they drank beer, and they had big beer parties. And I remember, it was a terrible thing. I was about six. No, I wasn't even six, but maybe five, between five and six. They went to an affair. My brother was there. He was 12. And they were drinking. And my brother, it was very uncharacteristic of him. But my mother and father were sitting with some other adult. A friend of his was a big, big, big policeman. Mm-hmm. And he went to sit down, and my brother pulled the chair out from under him. Mm-hmm. The man naturally got up and slapped my brother. And my father, much shorter but muscular too, did what a father would instinctively do. He would have slapped my brother. But this man did it first. So my father went after the big man. Mm-mm. And they beat him. Two men held my father, and this big man obliterated him practically. Mm-mm. And I remember screaming, running to my father, because I saw him being beaten. Mm-mm. I remember that. And I remember people reaching out to stop me, to grab me, which they did apparently, and that ended my mother and father's legion. My father and his friend made up eventually, but my father walked home with my brother. My brother caused it all. Mm-hmm. He wasn't a smart aleck. I don't know what he was thinking. Everybody's laughing and carrying. He was trying to be funny. Mm-hmm. It wasn't funny. But sometimes good things come out of bad, although it was very bad for me, because I'm not a brave person. My mother and father dropped out of the Legion. That ended that. And they stayed home and drank beer on weekends. My father was not an alcoholic. But on weekends, they partied, they had singing, everybody was everybody came to our house, singing, playing cards, laughing. But that did mark me. And then one time, and I was, and not in that house, in another house, I know I wasn't any more than three. And I remember very well, my mother's cousin was there, and her either ex-husband or ex-fiance, somebody she was either married to or going to marry, and she rejected him. Mm-hmm. She would not team up with him. Killed himself in my house, and I, at that age, opened the door. He went into the bathroom, got in the bathtub, and shot himself. And that whole bathroom was like it had been painted red.
Did you see him like that? Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah. So I was very scared.
Now how old were you at that point?
About 3 or 4. My mother was always taking people. And she wouldn't say no to, she liked people. And sometimes wrong things happen. But they were not alcoholics at all, but they did drink beer. And everybody liked our house. Everybody came to our house, the whole family, her family and their friends.
Mm-hmm. So when did he ask you to marry him?
Mm-hmm.
When did he ask you to marry him?
I forgot, after he got home from the Army, we were dating. I just was surprised.
Were you?
I really was. He came down and...
Were y'all dating?
Showed me this ring, and I said... He didn't say anything. I said, is that for me? No, I want you to see what some other girl think of it.
Were you dating just exclusively?
Yeah.
Him?
We were, yeah, by then we were just dating one another.
And you said yes or no?
I didn't even remember saying yes. I couldn't believe it. I said, oh, I went in and showed my mother. But I know before he left and went overseas, he sent me red roses, a dozen of them. And I sat up all night and stared at them. And I haven't seen a rose since.
A ring and a rose.
Ring and a rose. Ring around a rosy.
Not much on making speeches, apparently.
So where did y'all get married? Where what? Church?
January 31st, because I figured I will remember the last day of the month.
In a church?
Mm-hmm. I made my dress, and I can't even find it. It's somewhere.
Oh, my goodness.
I made my sister's wedding dress, too. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We were just not wealthy people. And my sister's son just gave his daughter... One daughter, or what, Danny, it cost him $20,000 to give his daughter a wedding. And it would never happen to me if I had $20,000. You just go your way.
Well, my dress was just a beach wedding dress. It was a simple little dress.
Oh, it was beautiful.
Just simple.
$20,000 and there are hungry children. If I had $20,000 to spend on a wedding, I wouldn't spend it on a wedding. I have a friend who offered his daughter a wedding for $10,000, and she took the wedding, and in a year, she was divorced. Mm-hmm. And I thought, you know, you could have $10,000 and gone on a trip.
Doesn't have to cost that much. That's ridiculous.
Can you imagine spending
$20,000? No. I can't see spending a whole lot of any money for any kind of party. That's what it is, a party.
Well, we got saved because the...
I thought we'd go on a picnic.
The only thing that saved us is the daughter-in-law had...
Was it what?
Made the video.
Patty, you?
Patty's daughter-in-law.
I can't hear you.
Patty's daughter-in-law filmed the wedding. Because our film didn't come out.
Did you see the great? Did you see the great Pyrenees dog?
Today, yeah.
Did you?
It was a mix, though.
Was it a mix?
Samoan. Just
like if I'd known you, would have got the top of your wedding.
See that big one?
Yeah.
That on the left, right there.
Yeah.
On the right now, that dog. There was a dog there, just like that.
Pyrenees, yeah, mix.
The great Pyrenees, mm-hmm. Yeah. I know somebody had one.
And the they Samoans are nice. I like the Samoans.
I have the top of my wedding cake yet. That the bride and groom, uh-huh. All they are is two little things. Uh-huh. And mm-hmm. I would have put it on your wedding cake if you had told me.
We didn't know you still had it.
Don't.
Did we have a top of the wedding cake? What happened? Mm-hmm. We didn't have
it. It didn't come in, remember? Oh. We ordered it, but it didn't come in.
Well, we had music in the car. We forgot.
You have what?
Music.
I had somebody else that I went to a wedding, and they had the canned music, too.
Well, this wasn't canned.
It was fine.
This was music that I specifically selected just for that occasion, and I burned it to a CD.
And
you forgot. So you should have reminded me.
You were in charge of the wedding.
Well,
I did
know.
All the decorations.
But you should have. I was there doing the decorations.
And this girl,
Ty and I did all the decorations. You were in charge for everything else.
That was a
good thing.
I was the
one that set up everybody.
To put it out.
But you should have reminded me, though, that you should have reminded me about it.
Yeah, it was a good thing you had your daughter and your grandchildren. Mm-hmm. And that's what this girl had. She had her two mm-hmm. children take her down the aisle. She was from Brazil. And she had a secondhand wedding dress. It was a great wedding.
Mine was a cute little
I thought yours
simple
was
dress.
Perfect.
It was a simple little thing.
And it didn't rain?
No.
And I saw a rainbow.
Rainbow in the morning.
And best of all, I had the letter from her daughter, from her sister and her grandmother in my suit. And then I had picked whatever one I picked. I read one of the ones I liked from her daughter, from her sister, and put that in there. And then when I went to read her grandmother's letters, the first one I picked up was dated October 4th, which was the day we got married. So, and then something was sitting right there, October 4th, right there. And that was her favorite person. And it was, there it was on the top of the pile.
So your first wedding anniversary's come out.
No, second.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Second.
Where did that time go?
2 years.
You know, it seems like yesterday I was 14.
Didn't
just yesterday.
I know, time goes by so fast.
And that was a good year, too. I had such fun.
That would have been 1941, I think. Yeah, that's 1941. Yeah, you were born in 27.
No, it would have been 40. No,
it 41. Yeah, 14 plus 27 is 41.
We had such fun when we were young. We just had a great time. We really did. But you know, I couldn't go down Myrtle Beach now to where we were. I could never do it. We had such fun that instead of having fun, I would just be grieving for the people that aren't there. They're all dead except myself, my sister, and another friend. Everybody else died. They all died.
I know, it's crazy. When I used to go home to the family reunions, I always missed.
Huh?
When I went home to my family reunions, I missed all the my grandmother and everybody that wasn't there. It wasn't the same.
Did they play games and all?
Mm-hmm. But they're starting, I don't think it's much of a reunion anymore. But all the good people are gone. All the originals started and they're gone.
Were there many people there?
The last one was quite a few, but not anywhere near.
Like 20?
Maybe, but it used to be like 80.
I have a friend that I used to go with her to her family reunions, and as the years went by, they were fewer and fewer. But they had games where the girls had to, the wives had to sew a patch on their husband's behind, or their jeans, you know, that sort of thing.
Johnny got to see the waterfall, the dam, didn't you?
Where?
Mm-hmm.
The, my grandfather helped build.
Douthat State Park is beautiful.
One of the first park rangers.
It was beautiful
over
there.
A park ranger? How wonderful.
He was one of the first when he got out of the service. Yeah? He was in World War I.
That was my father. He was the youngest, second youngest man in Maryland who joined the service. He was 14, lied about his age, and they took anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Skinny kid, got pneumonia, doing guard duty, got crap beat out of him. Because, and then he got pneumonia and wound up in the hospital. And that's how my grandmother found him.
But
can you imagine a 14-year-old being in the service?
Or an 18-year-old, just too young.
What a pretty girl.
Is that Carson?
Mm-hmm.
Carson, who I can't see.
Carson.
Oh, God, help us.
Trump tried to be friendly.
Hmm.
So he declared bankruptcy 11. Trump declared bankruptcy 11 times.
Did he?
And his one of his hotels is getting ready to close down, and it's going to be 3,000 people out of a job.
Well, there's something money wise in that.
Well, you know who pays for bankruptcy, right?
He'll come out smelling like a rose.
Everybody else pays for bankruptcy. He doesn't. Hmm. Yeah.
All right. What other stories can you tell? I remember going to get a soft crab sandwich from Glenmore Tavern.
I remember.
How long has that been selling soft crabs? Was that there selling soft crab sandwiches when you were a kid?
I don't remember. I remember a lot of crab feasts. My mother's arbor.
Yeah, I can bet.
With our whole family. We had a lot of good times.
Now, I remember sitting up under there. I don't remember ever having crabs under there, but I remember sitting up under there.
He was there many times.
Now, I'm saying we may have had crabs, but I don't remember crabs. But I remember sitting up under there.
You remember eating crabs as a kid?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think I must remember it.
You were one of his first cases when he got his law degree.
Who's that?
Our adoption.
Your father?
Funneled him through.
You're talking about your father?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Huh.
He didn't get out of sixth grade, and he still got a law degree. Just he educated himself through the years, and he failed the bar twice, and he would not quit. He took it a third time and got his degree.
What kind of lawyer was
he? He was a grandfather.
Well, what kind of lawyer was he?
He worked for a friend who was a very successful lawyer with the business and union people. He did strictly that, and he would give my father cases to sell estates, things like that, and some court things, but. He was very proud. One time he had to fly to Florida to settle an estate, and he ate in the tunnel instead of eating at a big hotel, which he could have done and charged it. He ate at the Tuttle House and places like that. He just did his job and went home. And he didn't live that long doing it, but he did what he wanted to do. He accomplished something. when you worked for the government, he was a government worker, and at that time, you could not have another job if you worked for the government. I don't know what it is now, but they would not allow you to earn a living otherwise, just work for them. So he had to wait until he retired to practice the law that he earned, you know. Oh, I'm tired.
See? I guess we better get down the road. Let her take her nap.
Well, let's see if we can get another story. Some other story.
Johnny.
Hey, let me finish what I'm doing. What other story can you think of, Mother?
She's asleep.
Well, maybe she did go to sleep long. I think she did.
She's tired.
Okay, Mother's tired. This is the end of the story. For now. Oh, now she opens her eyes. Are you back awake, Mother?
What?
You didn't realize you just went out to sleep for...
I don't know what you're saying. I can't...
You went to sleep for a second or two.
Who did?
You.
Well...
No, don't do it anymore.
She's tired,
huh? I know she's tired, but we're in the middle of this wonderful video. What other story can you tell us about somebody? I don't know who.
I don't know what you're talking...
Who else can you tell a story about? What other thing? Something about Nana. Tell me something about
Well,
Nana.
Well, we always had a garden.
Tell me a favorite story about Nana, because you told me a lot about your father, but tell me a favorite story about Nana.
She had a beauty license, a hair cutting shop in the front room, and she gave permanents and washed and set hair, and she just was active in the church, the church suppers and all that stuff. And she lived close enough to the church, and she was very active in it. And whenever they had an intern come that was learning to be a priest, they'd come to her house, and they'd get all the information, because she had it all.
Two died in a storm.
But I'm thinking a personal story with you and her. Something that you and her did that you remember.
I can't remember, except she was very good at teaching me to think of others, because I wanted a dress, an Easter outfit. I saw it in the paper, it was $15. Pleated skirt and top. I wanted it so bad, and she said I could get it, but I wouldn't have enough money to get your sister a new dress. And I thought I would feel terrible if I had a new dress and my sister didn't. And that made it okay. I thought, oh, I don't, it's okay. And then in order to protect myself, I took the attitude, don't have to get up and be in an Easter parade and have new clothes on Easter. So I went the opposite way. I would not get dressed up for Easter. That way I wouldn't be embarrassed by not having